Are all lekker the same, or is there a difference? No, obviously not all lekker are the same, because one, lekker is made out of different clay. So the people who make lekker go to a clay pit and they mine that clay and they put it through a rotary kiln, and that's how they get that lekker. So each lekker is specific to the pit that it was mined, the clay was mined from. So they're different. And you've got the red lekker, maybe that clay was a little bit redder. You've got the darker lekker like this one. So you can see already, just looking at my lekker, I've got different kinds of lekker. So this one looks a lot darker. It's got that, hang on. It's redder, whereas this one is gray. So you've got different kinds of lekker. And then I guess different kinds of manufacturing processes. Some lekker is rounder than other lekker. Some lekker is bigger. You've got the giant lekker. You've got micro lekker. You've got all sorts of different types of lekker. But obviously, I need to mention as well, just in case anybody is wondering, you've got ceramicite, which people like to call, you know, the little micro lekker, the colored lekker. It's green. It comes. It's pink. It looks lovely. But that's not really lekker, depending on what it is. Most of it is actually just, it's not lightweight and it's not aerated, it is not expanded like normal lekker is. So a lot of people who've used ceramicide actually mention that their plants don't do so well because, of course, it doesn't have the wicking properties that normal lekker does that you're supposed to use for growing your plants. So that's just something to keep in mind if you want to buy that pretty cute looking lekker that might potentially kill your plants. And then, of course, different brands are different. You know, they wash their lekker differently when they finish with the process of manufacturing. So all sorts of things determine what is good lekker. I know some people say, I don't like using this brand of lekker because it floats. When I put it in the water, it stays at the top, which I think is a little bit more problematic, maybe for people who are using deep water culture, maybe not so much for us who are using semi-hydroponics. So there are all sorts of things that make lekker different. But what I can say is, if you are not sure about what lekker brand to use, I would go to your local hydroponic shop, ask them what they stock, ask them what people around your area use. That's a good place to start. Go on Facebook groups where you've got people growing in semi-hydroponics, ask them what's a good brand to use. I mean, getting opinions from people who are actually using brands is a good way for you to know which is a brand to get for you.